Hey guys, Mr. Man here, and today I'm going to be showing you my updated version of my anti-Macleod Synchro Fiend deck, or my anti-meta deck, as a shorter version of it. So yeah, let's review what I'm doing. I've added a couple new cards. So yes, let's start. I run the Battle Fader, for in case they attack me directly, I can drop it. I run the usual, the Synchro Engine, 3 card guards. I added another Dark Necrofear because it helps me to banish monsters in my grave. Because then it gives me more options for Levier. Oh, excuse me. I run 2 Dark Resonators, Synchro Engine. I run the usual Darkness Necrosphere boss monster. I'm running 3 Gen Exiles Birdman because of 2 reasons. A, it speeds up the deck faster, and B, in case my opponent does something, aka Book of Moons, one of my monsters, and they go on tour guide. What I can do next turn, drop it. Then drop a tour guide again and get my thing. Or I can go into a level 6 synchro monster. Or exceed monster. Run 2 Weasels, just to help me if my monster is destroyed, and I can negate traps. I mean, not traps, spells. I run a Sangan for a searching. I run a Spirit Reaper, because it's a really good 3. And it cannot be destroyed by Gene Exile Birdman. And I run 2 again. For spell cards, I run a Lore of Darkness, because it's all darks. I run a Book, Moon. I run Essentials, Dark Hole, Heavy Storm, and MST. And Monster Reborn. I run 2 MSTs. A Pot of Average, because this attack really relies on the graveyard, so I run a lot of my monsters really fast. I'm gonna apply duality. Now I run a swords. And for traps, I run 2 BTHs, or bomb trap holes if you like to call it. I run 2 compulses. It helps with my monster and it helps with them by mostly using myself. Because in case they dark hole or trench in my field, I can do that. I run 3 Dark Bribes, because it pisses off my opponent when I run this, and it's a good way to stall. I run Escape from the Dark Mission, because I banish a lot, so it's a good way to use this card. I run 3 Fiendish Chains, because it helps me to negate effects, and it also helps that I'm negating a lot of effects, and today's decks rely on effects a lot, so if I negate a couple effects, then it helps me grant the win for this deck. I run a Mirror Force, Odd Judgment, and 2 Solemn Warnings, and a Trench of Tribute. Besides, I run a second Escape from the Dark Dimension, I run a second Darkness Necrosphere, I run a new card, Final Gesture, because it's pretty much a tour guide and a wind-up rabbit combined. Because if no one doesn't know what it does, it targets once for level 3 in your control. Special summon a monster with the same name as that monster from your hand or graveyard. Its effects are negated during the end phase of this turn. This sort of phase of monster that is targeted by this card. So pretty much, it's an amazing card. I run a Marshmallow for Renland, and I run a second Swords. And for my extra deck, I run Age of Fairy Dragon, Black Rose Dragon, Chaos Guardian Archmage, 3 Dark Highlander. I added Gem Knight Pearl, another Levier, because this deck banishes a lot and it just helps to summon banished monsters. I run a Mithraism because it's a fiend monster also. So yeah, and that was my Facebook message. Yeah, someone just messaged me. I run a Giga Brilliant, Utopia, Aeroshock, and two Zen mains. So yeah, that's my updated anti-matter synchro fiend deck, or anti-matter deck. So hope you liked it. Please subscribe for more videos. And until next time, YouTube, Z Mr. Man, signing out.